Welcome to Cusina ni Luz. Today I'm going to present some of the many Korean side dishes, or what they call panchan. Usually, panchan are homemade. However, most mom or wives are busy working, so they prefer to buy ready-to-eat side dish, available at the supermarket or panchan store. Let's start from the very famous pechu kimchi or pechai. This is an internationally recognized Korean food. Do you know there exist 200 varieties of kimchi? However, they are not available all throughout the year. Most of them are made based on the season. So before winter comes, most kimchi are made. And usually, Koreans stock up as much as they can until the next spring arrives. That's why Koreans have their separate kimchi freezer. This is a stuffed cucumber or owi sobaki. During Korean spring, they harvest a lot of cucumber or pipino, so they start to make kimchi out of it. This type of kimchi doesn't last long compared to the pechu kimchi. Cucumber kimchi can only last for a week or two before it starts to taste sour. Also, the cucumber becomes more watery, so it loses its crunchiness. Most Koreans doesn't really like their food too sour, so they only make a small amount of owi sobaki. As we all know, cucumber is really good for the skin. Here we have shredded radish or musengchi in Korean, and we call that labanos in the Philippines. Radish is one of the many vegetables available from springtime to autumn season. That's why many types of kimchi are made out of radish. Or they put radish as part of its ingredients. There are many types of radish in Korea. I will show them to you next time. There are also kimchi made from fish. Anchovy is the most popular. We call it myeolchi or dilis in Filipino. Rich with calcium, this is not spicy like many kimchi. And dried anchovy is always available at the grocery. So we can have this all year round. Some myeolchi have almond and sesame seed together with its ingredients. And some have green pepper based on the region who made the panchan. Here is the salted squid, or what we call ujingo in Korea. It is actually pusit in Filipino. This is a fresh salted squid, although sometimes it looks like an earthworm to me. This one, although it's red and looks spicy, it is also salty. It is salty more than the myeolchi. You need to eat a small portion of this together with your rice. so you will not taste that much saltiness. With this small amount, it can actually last for a week. It's like bagoong in the Philippines. Do you know what is a bellflower? I guess we don't have this in the Philippines, but maybe you have it in your country. Koreans actually eat the root that looks like ginseng. It's a little bit bitter, but tastes just good like the ampalaya in the Philippines. Sometimes they add squid into the ingredient to add more taste and variety. You can also see cucumber and fresh onions on it. Last but not least is japchae. I really don't know why they call it glass noodles. Maybe because the noodles are transparent just like a glass before it is actually cooked. It's like pancit sotanghon in my country. But the noodles are a bit larger. The vegetables on top are actually cooked separately. And the oil that they use is sesame oil, not simply cooking oil. Here's one way of serving them directly from the individual container or put them on a nice plate. There you go. Next time, I will show you more Korean food. Bye!